at last. Lieutenant Backstrom is coming. I, too, would like to go home at night.
Look, I was driving Backstrom here for his appointment, and then he got a very important phone call. Right? But he insisted I come here and tell you in person, so...
What kind of important call?
A summons from the head of the Civilian Oversight Committee. Thank you for coming.
I'm not going to say no to a booty call.
First thing I said on the phone is this is not a booty call.
And yet, we're headed towards your bedroom.
Because that is where the possum is.
Yeah, you know what? I'm not hearing anything.
Maybe he went away on his own?
You know, if you're lonely, you don't need to make up stories about rabbit possums in your bedroom.
Let's discuss our delusions after you get rid of the possum.
Let's do this.
Okay, you weren't kidding.
You've got a wild animal probably pooping Ebola on your bed.
Oh, God.
Here's $18. Go stay at a hotel.
Where, in 1952?
Text. Oh, shoot. Duty calls. I need you to get me a ride.
How did you get here?
Valentine, but he took off.
Why?
Because he knew this was a booty call.
Evening, Lieutenant. Why'd you take a cab?
That's what grown people do when they need to get somewhere.
The victim is Vanessa Tamor, age 44.
Blunt force trauma consistent with being struck and run over by an automobile.
What, that spaceship?
No, that vehicle was registered to the victim.
Oh, right, because that battery-operated vanity toy probably couldn't go fast enough to kill someone.
This is Vanessa Tamor. Vanessa Tamor, the former venture capitalist who made a bajillion dollars before she retired. She's married to Tad Tamor. Tad Tamor?
Stop saying Tad Tamor.
Famous former tennis player.
So the victim is rich. That's why we're here. A rich person gets hit and runned, the big guns get called in. Is that it?
Bertolt Brecht says corpses sour you. They're bad for objectivity.
Niedermeyer, seriously.
This overlapping pattern of forward and backward centrifugally formed impressions suggests otherwise. I think that the driver struck Vanessa Tamor here. She popped up onto the hood, cracked the windshield, and she landed here. And then the driver then slams on his brakes, causing these skid marks, jams it in reverse, burning rubber here, backing over the victim while she lay prone on the ground, and then slamming on his brakes again here, and then floors it into forward, hitting the victim for a third time before continuing out on the exit. I mean, at least that's the way I see it.
I'm officially declaring this a hit, another hit, another hit, and run. Thank you. Thank you. That's good, right? You gotta really hate someone to run over them that many times. Obviously, the husband did it. Somebody with balls big enough to pretend that tennis is a real sport. And rich enough to think that he could drive away with murder. Putting him in jail with the bottom 1%, oh, that's gonna be fun.
It's about time you called. You got the husband in custody?
He's in the hospital, but the doctor says he can't talk to us.
Just pick me up on the way.
The doctor says...
A rich bastard can't hide behind a note from his doctor. Okay? And give me a coffee.
I made it clear that Mr. Tamor is unable to speak right now.
Oh, did he pay you off to say that?
Mr. Tamor is sedated. I'll call you when he wakes.
Oh, what happened? Did he split open his nose on the steering wheel when he ran over his wife?
Mr. Tamor has stage 4 lung cancer. As a participant in a blind experimental treatment protocol, he hasn't left the hospital in 6 weeks. Excuse me.
Terminal cancer, wow. Talk about overdoing it with the alibi.
Lieutenant Backstrom.
Oh, hey, gravely, this is my doctor, Deb. Back in his home country of Tanduristan, he is the sultan of surgery, but here he just works for the police union.
I'm here visiting a patient who needed surgery, just like I'll visit you when you're here for your quadruple bypass.
Okay.
You've missed 3 appointments. Do you have a good reason?
Yes, I do. It's not terminal cancer, but it's a pretty good reason.
Miss one more appointment and I will have to withdraw your provisional fitness certification. Nice to meet you, Detective Gravy, and you have my deepest sympathies.
And I feel your pain, Dr. Shaman.
Dr. Shaman? Deb is his first name.
I was able to access the victim's contact and digital calendar.
Hotel events manager corroborates that she was there, checking out facilities.
She has a curious appointment today.
2 p.m. MJ at M's?
Mm-hmm, and that same appointment recurs every Thursday, so I went online to check for clues on what MJ stands for, and guess what? Marijuana.
So M's her dealer?
And there's also Michael Jackson, Moose Jaw, Monster Jam, Mechanical Joint, and Megajoule.
So she has weekly energy meetings?
And Moose Jaw?
You guys are mocking me. Okay, so what do you think it stands for, you smarty pants boys?
Mahjong. Rich ladies play Mahjong in the afternoon. M is her friend who hosts.
How do you know about Mahjong?
My mom used to make me go to after school programs when I was a kid, funded by rich ladies, and every now and then I had to put on a suit and tie and go by and say thank you.
During Mahjong.
Oh yeah, they love it.
Uh-huh. And her favorite contact? Meredith. No last name.
I can get my hat.
Vanessa was a force of nature. She did so much good work.
Vanessa was part of your group.
Yes. We loved her very much.
Wait a minute. How come there's eight of you here?
Excuse me?
Mahjong is played in groups of four. But your friend just got killed, which would leave you a man down. Which means you knew she was not going to make it today. Which means you knew she was going to get murdered.
Ladies?
No matter what Vanessa said to anybody, it was her decision to quit Mahjong.
And why do you think she'd go and do that, huh? Because she was loved too much?
You're a very rude man.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. He's not the one playing dominoes and getting drunk a day after your friend was murdered.
We have nothing more to say.
Really? Why is that? Because the Botox has frozen your face so much? Or are you really just a pack of cold, soulless frauds who have squeezed out every ounce of human decency in order to fit in those dresses? And who care more about society secrets than the death of your BFF?
Get out!
Arrest them all. Give them nothing but fatty foods and tap water. They'll talk.
Together on the boards of non-profits, attend each other's charitable fundraisers, etc. And our victim, Vanessa Taymor's pet charity is the homeless.
Literacy, women's issues, cancer, parks beautification. Backstrom told you to arrest all of them on what grounds?
And I quote, for being rich bitches. Don't worry, I didn't arrest anyone.
Have we figured out why Vanessa Taymor was ejected from the group?
They refused to talk, and they called their lawyers.
You should try the opposite of Backstrom test politely.
Ladies, here's the tea I promised. This is the peach blossom mint infusion. It was blessed by a Tibetan monk friend of mine. You were saying about Vanessa Taymor. The reason she left?
Vanessa quit playing Mahjong because of Donald Sampson.
The racist video guy?
Alleged racist.
The video shows Donald Sampson repeatedly using barbaric racial slurs in reference to both blacks and Hispanics.
He wasn't about to get rich. He could sell a load of crap to the scum of the earth. By scum, I mean blacks, browns, yellow ones, you name it. The oldest trick in the book.
It's terrible. It's inexcusable. I am led to understand, though, that the tape may not be real. Which is why I felt that we should wait before rejecting his charitable donations.
Vanessa Taymor felt that it would be wrong to take Donald Sampson's money for her homeless charity.
Oh, she felt it would be wrong for all of us. Caused quite a rift. Personally, I say suck every guilty dime you can out of the guy. Detective, we had a spat. Vanessa quit Mahjong. Not worth murder.
People are saying that an angry mistress posted the video. It's got 8 million plus views, and the stock in Sampson Sports Company is falling fast.
That's why I prefer prostitutes. You can trust them.
You know, it's an interesting dilemma for charities. Do you take dirty money or not?
It is an interesting dilemma, except for, of course you take the money.
Detectives, Mr. Taymor is awake.
There's no chance it was an accident?
None. You know anyone that would do something like that to your wife?
No, Vanessa was a wonderful, kind, generous woman. Everyone loved her.
Your wife was trying to organize various charities to reject donations from Donald Sampson. It was causing quite a fuss in your social circle.
I've known Don since college. He only cares about the bottom line. Not a society lady refusing his money. They're giving me a wonder drug.
more sugar water. To tell you the truth, I don't care about Vanessa gone.
Well, listen, do you think your wife maybe was having an affair with Samson and then released the video when everything went south?
No, my wife would never cheat on me.
Well, you have been sick for a long time.
Lieutenant?
No.
Do you want to look at your dream board while I take some blood?
No. There's too many pictures of Vanessa.
What's this? Someone forced a bunch of kids to make this for you?
Mr. Taymor made it. Focusing mental energy on positive images can create health miracles.
Wow. More money than God, and all you get is experimental medicine and a crappy art project. That's gotta sting.
Please, just find who killed my Vanessa. Think of it as a deathbed wish.
Feast your eyes on this yellow purse. Sitting phantom, pebbled leather, divine. The victim's husband bought it for her on their 15th anniversary. She never left home without it.
That's his problem.
No, but it wasn't recovered at the scene or in her car or her home.
She's saying the killer dumped the contents and stole the purse?
I would kill for that purse.
Looks like some other crazy woman already beat you to it. Get warrants for all of her friends' homes, the Mahjong monsters. We're going purse shopping.
What's this, Arson Crabs Day?
This is a dream board. Focusing my mental energy on the amazing things I want in my life can create health miracles. I want Dr. Deb to know how desperate I am to get better.
All right.
Did you find that ugly purse?
Nah, me and Detective Allman, we went through four mansions. You know, I had no idea people could be so rich.
It's exactly how they like it.
Yeah. I don't know if pictures of cigars and liquor bottles are going to convey the right message, Lieutenant.
What am I supposed to put on my dream board?
Rich people stuff. Nice cars, pet giraffes, courtside trailblazer seats. Beyonce, stuff like that.
Lieutenant, it's a dream board. I'm not finished. To Vanessa, 15 years gone, 100 to go. Love, Ted.
We found this in the home of Kristen Kelly.
Ah, the ugly yellow purse killer.
My wife has a problem.
Yeah, killing her friends.
She's been diagnosed with kleptomania, a mental disorder for which there is no cure.
Well, the good thing about jail is that will cut down on her stealing considerably.
In addition to a sworn statement from Kristen's psychiatrist, I have receipts from hundreds of stores we reimbursed for stolen merchandise, establishing a clear pattern of theft. This stolen purse and the tragic death of our dear friend Vanessa are purely coincidental, and you, sir, have no evidence to prove otherwise. I rest my case.
I don't know what law school your daddy bought in order to get you a degree, but you need to stop talking right now. I'm you. I'm a moronic lawyer's aging trophy wife. The only way I get self-esteem is by being the charity cancer queen of Portland. Then Vanessa comes along. She's prettier. She's richer. And luckily for her, her husband is actually dying of cancer. She's gonna take my place as the queen of cancer. So I run her over and over and over and over.
No, that is not what happened.
You killed her, and you ripped this out of her cold, dead hands. Took it home as a trophy.
Yes, I was there.
Being somewhere is not a crime.
Vanessa and I were reviewing the hotel facilities for an upcoming cancer event. Vanessa self-parks. It's her thing. I went out front, but my driver was not there.
Your driver?
I heard screeches, and I saw a car, a white luxury coupe, drive away. When I found Vanessa, she was already dead, and it was very upsetting. And stress is what makes me steal, so I took the bag. But I left everything that was important, the phone and the wallet and everything.
Your crap lawyer should have advised us that you didn't have access to a car, considering you're being accused of committing a hit and run.
Ah! I'm a tax lawyer.
Lieutenant?
Ah. Oh, no. Here we go. What?
I have a rendering of the white luxury hit and run vehicle as described by Kristen to the Bureau sketch artist.
Yeah, very lifelike. Is this what you're bothering me about?
No, I'm bothering you on doctor's orders.
Oh, come on. No one asked you to make a fire escape call.
I came to give you this.
What is it?
That's a pedometer, sir. Measures how many steps you take in a day.
Helpful not only for physical fitness, but to help you sleep, as I will not be replenishing your prescription.
You know what? I could arrest you for talking about my problems outside of your office.
But you won't come to my office.
Maybe if you let me smoke there, I would.
My struggle is to keep you alive. Luckily, the speedometer will send me updates without your help. If you take less than 10,000 steps, I yank your fitness certificate.
None of this matters, because I am making a dream board, which can cause miracles.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
But visualization techniques work best with an unaddled soul. Bring it to my office and we'll discuss it.
Okay, Niedermeyer, I need you to make me a dream board. It's this collage.
I'm aware of the concept, sir, but you can't build somebody else's dream board.
Why not?
Because dreams are an expression of subconscious desires. And if I build your board, it would be expressing my subconscious, and I guarantee you that Dr. Deb would know the difference.
I knew it was a scam.
Hey.
What now?
4 days ago, before she was murdered, our victim had a very loud, very public argument with the director of the downtown mission.
Yeah, but I guarantee our homeless lover doesn't drive any fancy white car.
Maybe not. He's a former junkie, a former armed robber, and a former car thief.
Mission is close. You could walk and get a jump on those 10,000 steps.
You could jump off this fire escape. But I guess we'll both have to live disappointed.
Come on, come on through.
Stand back.
Whoa. Sloppy Joe's.
No?
You wouldn't stop for pizza.
Come on. Excuse me.
Hey, come on.
Not bad.
Hey, one per person.
One per homeless person.
The rules are for everyone. Put it back.
It's half eaten, but I guess you're used to that.
You cut in line.
Easy. You're pushing it.
Oh, I'm gonna push it.
Are ya?
Yeah.
Yes, Vanessa and I argued. And I'm bummed that was our last interaction. She was a great human being.
What did you argue about?
Donald Sampson.
The racist.
Sampson is to be presented with our Mission Angel of the Year award in return for a $50,000 donation.
Vanessa Tamar wanted to pull that award.
Yep, but I'm a practical man. The trophy costs $10. In return, we get $50,000.
Go ahead. Stand up. I dare you.
All right, back up.
Jim, calm down. Calm down. Whoa.
Bastion, you all right?
I'm okay. I'm a cop. I have a gun. I pay taxes. I have a job.
I have a job.
Collecting cans is not a job. I work for Mr. Donald Sampson. What?
What do you do for him?
Mr. Sampson pays me $50 to feed quarters into his parking meter.
Outside the shelter?
No, when you're the Hotel Vivian.
When was the last time you did that?
Yesterday.
That doesn't make sense. Why spend $50 to avoid a $15 ticket?
So there's no record of him ever being there. He's having an affair with our victim. I knew it. To the Batcave, Robin.
Wait a minute. Robin rides shotgun like you do. If anyone's Batman here, it's me. And shouldn't you be walking?
Good point. Hey, Sloppy Joe. Here's $5. Walk to the police station for me. To the Batcave, Alfred.
Donald Sampson checked in twice a week under a fake name and paid cash.
And you found that out how?
The lieutenant had a fist fight with a homeless man over Sloppy Joe's. I don't think Bastion got in a punch. It's like a turtle lying on its back.
Hey, the room at the Vivian matches the room in Sampson's disgraceful video. Vanessa leaks it, Sampson kills her.
A fundraising crusader and a racist corporate pig make a really weird couple.
Actually, they've known each other for a very long time. Because in the early 90s, Vanessa's husband, Tad, beat Sampson to win something called the NCAA championship. Is that a big deal?
Pretty big deal, yeah.
So Sampson never forgets and sees an opportunity for revenge by sleeping with Tamar's wife. Well, women have needs, and her husband is sick and unable to fill her.
That is exactly what the lieutenant said to the sick husband.
Well, how thoughtful of him.
So then she finds out what a monster he is and leaks this video.
And to stop her from leaking any other secrets, runs her over in a fancy white coupe.
Is this enough for us to get a warrant to search the cars for damage?
It's not even enough evidence to call him on the telephone.
We really need an excuse to look at those vehicles.
Jingle for Jungle Gems. It's a fundraiser that gets playground equipment for inner city kids. It's happening at the Sampson house tonight.
Of course. If you're gonna have a public event in your property, then there's no reasonable expectation for privacy. Good job, Little. We can search for evidence and take photos and samples, and it's all admissible.
Yeah. Whoa. $10,000 a table?
I'm gonna call the chief. Said he's bound to have tickets.
Yeah, and I'm gonna call the lieutenant and tell him to pull out his formal poncho.
So, it's a charity fundraiser?
Yes.
Tonight?
4 hours from now, I'm supposed to look like a rich bastard.
And it's black tie.
Yes.
And you actually care about the dress code, because why?
It's a municipal who's who. I might run into somebody important.
Oh. Amy? You are really gonna need my help.
Will you or won't you?
I will if I can be your rich bastard date.
Sure.
Now the fanciest thing I'd ever been to was a Hungarian wedding. I don't think we should drink.
We're undercover. And this is not the cheap stuff. Go. Will you let him?
Looks like the footprint of the house matches what we were able to access from public records.
Samson keeps his car collection in a 20-car garage on the southern side of the property.
My God, you are beautiful.
Damn, Bouquet. You fit in good.
Hey.
Okay, I see you.
You clean up.
You're stunning.
Has anybody seen the lieutenant?
Turn down for what?
Is that Backstrom?
Turn down for what?
Yeah.
Turn down for what?
Oh, God.
Yep, that's Backstrom, all right.
The hit and run car. Lieutenant Baxter? This is unexpected. Chief Savant has given the special crimes unit her table. Sure, the chief didn't want to be seen hobnobbing with Samson, huh? Notice the mayor isn't here either. In fact, nobody good is here. Yeah.
Punch her in her Botox.
Later.
What do you got?
The garage has two doors. One's down the hall past the kitchen. That's the one that most likely will be unlocked.
Yeah, and there are security guards, but they're mostly concerned with steering people towards the porta potties. Very gauche.
Porta potties.
Hey, need a mic. Hey, what's going on?
Nothing, you just dance.
Niedermeyer, will you stop fiddling with Valentine? Get Moto, go to the garage and find that car. Door, but it's locked.
Maybe it's just stuck.
Now people this rich don't have sticky doors.
All right. I'm gonna kick it in.
No.
What? The murder vehicle might be behind this door.
If you kick this door and everything behind it is inadmissible.
That's what the lieutenant would do.
Well, exactly. Yeah. All right, so the doors are locked.
Okay, what about the outside entrance?
It's too well lit.
We can get a warrant if we can see in the windows.
There are no windows.
Not a chance, Twinkie boy.
It's Twink, Frenchie.
Looking for me?
This is literally the last place I would expect to find you.
Working on a case. You?
Well, someone from the city had to be here, and I like the cause. Plus, I have experience with insufferable blowhards.
Uh-huh. You want to dance? I have to take 10,000 steps, or my Dr. Dab will ground me. Long story.
Yes, please.
Admit it, I look amazing.
Just need to tell me how good I look before fisting for compliment.
Oh, that's how it works. I'm a better dancer than you remember. Isn't that true?
I remember you being pretty good. So, why are you really here?
Are you following me?
You flatter yourself. I'm actually undercover. Yeah, go ahead and say it. Very James Bond.
Oh, chain-smoking, martini-swigging from a scared sociopath? Yeah, I've outgrown that type.
You look amazing. And I should have said that first.
Thank you. I'm champagne and scotch, so I'm guessing there's probably vodka going on there as well.
I'm working undercover.
My dad was an alcoholic.
I know.
He wrestled with it his whole life. Before he died, he gave me this.
Oh. He quit drinking and started gambling?
It's a 30-day chip from Alcoholics Anonymous. It's my inheritance.
You carry it around with you?
Everywhere. Always. Until now. I want you to have it until you earn your own.
So that's the deal. I quit drinking, join AA. And we give this another try.
I'm not making any kind of a deal here, Everett. If I did something to give you the impression I wanted to try again, I apologize because I don't.
We both know that's not true.
I just wanted to be friends. But I guess that isn't gonna happen.
Uh-oh. He's walked to the bar.
Double vodka on the rocks. Hold the rocks. Double the vodka.
Heavenly Father, we beseech you. Please don't let Baxton speak to Samson.
Women, am I right? You're not gay? Why, because I shaved?
I just saw you come in with that stunning creature.
Him? He's just my gay tenant. Woman that I love. Never mind. So you a rich guy? You got rich guy hair.
I'm Donald Sampson.
Talk about woman problems.
Excuse me?
Well, that post-coital video that got leaked.
Enjoy the rest of your evening.
You know what I'd do? I'd kill the bitch that leaked the video. Then run her over with my car. Maybe a couple of times.
Bartender, another drink for my clever friend.
Yes, sir.
Another one, please.
Uh-oh. Double vodka, no ice, double the vodka. What's wrong? You okay?
Yeah. I'm fine. Highlight of my evening was Donald Sampson thinking that we were a couple. He called you a stunning creature.
Oh, well, now that sounds like an invitation.
No, not in the way that would lead him to buy you fancy things.
Why don't you let me be the judge of that?
Okay, yeah, good luck with that.
There won't be anyone like you in my life again. Someone who always tells the truth, lies would suffice instead. And who am I supposed to call to tell me what to do? You say I shouldn't care.
That was fast.
You were right. He's rendezvousing with a woman. I think his wife?
I doubt that.
Let's go.
I wanted to hurt you for threatening to go back to your wife, not ruin you. I hate myself for leaking that video. I swear.
You are the most expensive fling I have ever had.
What am I touched into, Arsley? Certainly not sleeping with his wife.
Or the murder victim. Samson didn't kill her.
Are you sure?
She didn't leak the video. Which means maybe a rich person didn't do the murder, which means maybe we've been looking for the wrong car. Niedermeyer, is it possible the sketch could have been of a poor person's white car?
It's very possible. In fact, as the science of aerodynamics has gotten more and more refined, there's less and less diffusion.
Oh, no! I'm not drunk enough for your garbage. I'm going home. Everything about this event disgusts me.
You all right, Lieutenant?
Let Moto give you a ride.
No! Gotta walk. 10,000 steps. Hot. Hot.
Cheer up. You got quite the workout last night.
Oh, that's disgusting.
What?
You were right.
That's the least stupid thing I've ever heard you say.
We found 3 white cars that match the police sketches, but only one of them has traces of blood on the tires.
So who's the car belong to?
Well, that's the thing.
It's a flash car, which is a drop-off pickup rental service.
So, trace the account. The renter is the killer.
Okay, Allman is running the VIN, and alas...
Oh, don't say alas to the lieutenant first thing in the morning if you want to make it to the afternoon. Hey, the rental account belongs to the victim.
Wait, so she was run over by her own rental car?
Paquette thinks that the flash car is not a dead end.
Whoa. Come on, quiet. Some of us are trying to have a hangover.
All that's needed to create an account is a credit card number and its billing address. So here's a list of people Vanessa gave this credit card to, mostly from her charities, people making purchases on her behalf. The killer is on the list. It's someone who had access to her information.
Okay, here's what we need to do. Go back to basics. What did Vanessa Taymor do to deserve getting run over?
Excuse me? Oh, Amy rejected him, so now he hates all.
We're assuming that the victim was this kind, lovable, wonderful person. Well, most women really aren't.
Oh, good God. Her life had only 2 aspects, her charity work and her husband.
We've already gone over the charity work.
You think the husband did it? He's dying, and he loves her.
Love is a myth, invented by teenagers in the diamond industry.
Is anyone on that credit card list linked to the husband? Okay, well, his nutritionist used it for vitamins, his private chef, oh, yes, and his driver for gasoline. Oh.
Oh, what? Oh.
Well, there were 5 separate donations for $20,000 each to Cancer Solutions, but wait, Cancer Solutions isn't a charity. It's an LLC. And Dr. Bai is the sole proprietor.
You see how right it feels when everything pulls together. Vanessa Taymor was bribing you to make sure her husband got the drugs instead of the placebo. You got nervous someone would find out, so you ran her over with a car.
That money wasn't a bribe.
No?
I'm a researcher. Grants are extremely hard to get. Vanessa wanted to help.
I hope you're a better doctor than you are a liar.
Mr. Taymor isn't receiving the experimental drug. He's in the control group.
Interesting.
Wait, where are you going?
Lieutenant!
Mr. Taymor, where's your nurse clicker thing? Nurse!
What's going on?
Let me get you some Jell-O. Nurse!
You need something?
Yeah. I'll have a drink of whatever he's having. Go ahead. Do it.
Your world is very dark.
You call it dark. I call it woefully predictable. So, if this is the placebo, I should be fine, right?
What if it isn't?
You'll have a seizure, perhaps go blind.
Maybe you should think about this for a second.
We're gonna need a bigger dream board.
Oh, dream board. New and improved. Much less wife.
Those images were too painful. It defeats the purpose.
Interesting fact about dream boards. They reflect the subconscious desires of the people that make them. But rich people don't have subconscious desires to live in mansions because they actually do. And they actually drive fancy cars and they actually go on exotic vacations. You didn't make this. She did.
Brittany helped, so what?
This is her dream board, not yours. Subconscious never lies. Is Nursey and Paquette's list of those who had access to the credit card?
Yes.
She did it. She rented the car. Check her computer.
Do I have your permission to search this computer? No, you do not.
Now you have administrative privileges.
You, a lot of people can get at this computer. It's a very public place.
I'm you. Burned out nurse, tired of 12-hour shifts changing bedpans.
And then I meet a filthy rich guy. Or at least he will be, once his wife is out of the way. And he's gonna need someone to lean on. And that someone could be me. I could comfort him. Get him to depend on me. Fall in love with me. Marry me. And the best thing is, he's got a shelf life of what? A year? And it's all mine.
I got it. A flash car account was created on this computer the day before the murder. Brittany Gottman logged in at 2.05 a.m. At 2.15, a confirmation email was sent from flash car, and at 2.20, she logged out.
You are a very naughty nurse.
You're done. You can get dressed now. Your liver tells me you haven't quit drinking. Your pallor tells me you aren't sleeping, and I've seen with my very own eyes that you haven't stopped smoking. When you finally fall of a heart attack or stroke or whatever inevitable malady takes you, they will turn to me and say, how could you find him fit to work?
Oh, so it's about you.
The worst part about your worldview is that it's contagious. Those of us around you begin to see ourselves as you see us. You think I'm a terrible doctor? I become a terrible doctor.
No, not so terrible. I have 10,000 steps. My feet are killing me.
It's merely a machine that counts what the machine part of you is achieving.
There's a machine part of me?
It measures activity. You like activity because it allows you to avoid reflection. It is reflection which leads us to our true best selves, not activity.
So the pedometer is stopping me from reaching my true best self.
Perhaps another doctor would have better luck.
I don't want another doctor.
You joined a program?
I didn't want to come see you until I could prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that you had, in fact, helped me become my true best self. Thank you. Thank you.
Good for you.
Thank you, Dr. Sharman.
Good for you.
Okay.
Good for both of us. You must wear the pedometer. I will check on it daily to see how many steps you have taken.
Fantastic. Because you know what they say in the program? One step at a time.
One day at a time.
That's what I said. Learn to speak English sometime. Free.
What does that mean?